The child protection advocacy group Bravehearts has launched a new awareness campaign tonight, saying it wants to make Australia a safer place for our kids to grow up, because right now the statistics suggest it is not that safe at all. 1 in 5 of our children is sexually assaulted before they turn 18. Bravehearts says that means 59,000 Australian children every year. They want to cut that figure in half by 2020. Some states are safer than others. Queensland ranked the best for its programs to protect children, followed by New South Wales and Victoria. But even Queensland has room to improve. Today, a commission of inquiry handed down more than 100 recommendations to overhaul the state's child protection system. Well, Hetty Johnston, Bravehearts founder and executive director, was instrumental in that inquiry, and she joins me now from Brisbane. Now, Hetty, let's define our terms. 1 in 5 children is an enormously high number. What is, for the purposes of this, a sexual assault?
Well, sexual assault ranges from the more, in inverted commas, minor offences, such as being exposed, a child being exposed by an adult to sort of genitals, or exposed to pornography, or exposed to images of sexual adult sexual content, right through to the high-end cases of rape and torture, in fact.
Obviously, this is not discussing gender in that 1 in 5 number. Presumably, it's more likely that girls are exposed to it. Is that a fair assumption?
Yes, in fact, the statistic 1 in 5 does seem very hard to believe. That how could this be possible? How could this happen? It's actually 1 in 3 girls and 1 in 4 boys, which in fact relates to 1 in 4.5 children. But we say 1 in 5, and these are numbers that are common really across the Western world. They're not argued. We all understand that's the problem we're having to deal with.
And what's the impact on those girls and boys as they grow into adulthood?
Well, historically, when we didn't talk about it and we didn't offer help and we didn't have services, the impact was enormous. So we're talking about suicide and mental health issues and family breakdown, sexual dysfunction, crime, all of these things where society keeps creating all these new charities to mop up this carnage. Most of it, much of it, comes from child sexual assault. Hopefully today things have changed. You know, for children who get the right kind of support, for children who are believed and supported, the outcomes are wonderful for them. I mean, there is hope. It's not a death sentence.
Well, you're trying to halve that statistic. You're fundraising to that end. How will money change that number?
Well, Bravehearts' mission, if you like, is to make Australia the safest place in the world to raise a child. And this isn't sort of a whimsical thing. This is absolutely possible and doable if only we apply educate, empower and protect. So educate all our children to know how to stay safe, empower those people that are working and living with children so they understand what the indicators are, they can see it, they know how to respond effectively. And then, of course, protect, meaning that legislations, policies and practices are in place. And when, for those children that do fall through the cracks, that there is specialised child sexual assault counselling services available to them. We know this will do it. We just need the money to get the programs, to finish off the research, develop the programs and get cracking.
Hetty, do the laws need to be tougher? Do they need to be looked at again on the issue of sexual privacy? Because there is ample evidence that particularly the young and naive might find themselves in sexual situations. Perhaps they even consent to pictures being taken of them having sex, perhaps between them and their partner. It then goes out on all the digital platforms that are available. Do we need tougher laws to punish people who invade sexual privacy in that way?
I think we're dealing with an absolute phenomenon here, in that this is such an... The technology is evolving so fast. Our children and our young people are growing up in a highly sexually charged environment. I don't think that young people really understand. They're young, they haven't quite matured, they're risk takers, and they're taking huge risks in doing this, but they're not really understanding that cyber echo means it will come back. And Bravehearts are working with Google at the moment in developing programs to actually deal with this. It is a huge problem. It's a massive problem. And we have to reach out to the young people and explain, you know, why this is such dangerous behaviour.
You have plenty of noble work ahead of you. Hetty Johnston, thanks very much for joining us there from Brisbane tonight.
Thank you.